Number two, find the volume of the tank if it was half full. Since I'm trying to see what the volume is if it's half full, I'm first going to find the volume of this cylinder and then I can divide by two. That'll give me the volume when it's half full. So here, this is a cylinder. So first things I'm going to do is I'm going to go to my formula chart and find the volume for a cylinder. When I do that, volume of a prism or cylinder is volume equals area of my base times my height. So this is V equals the area of my base times my height. Now, this capital B stands for area of my base, so I need to identify my base shape, which is a circle. So going back to my formula chart, the area of my base shape was, which is a circle, the formula is area equals pi times r squared. So here I'm going to substitute this as pi times r squared times my height, which is times my height. So substituting in my numbers, I'm first going to substitute in pi times r squared. Now here this line goes all the way across, so this is indicating to me that a stands for the diameter. I need my radius. So if my diameter equals 8, my radius is half of that diameter, which means my radius is 4. So this is pi times 4 squared. Now my height is the distance between my base shapes, so my height here is going to be 10. So now I want to simplify the area of my base. So pi times 4 squared in my calculator. So pi times 4 squared. I get 50.26. And I'm going to simplify that to the tenths place. This is going to be 50.3. And I'm going to multiply that by the height, which is 10. So 50.3 times 10, we get 503. So here, the volume of this tank is 503. However, I want to find the volume when it is half full. So I'm going to divide this by two. So 503 divided by two. And to convert that to a decimal, we convert it by pressing menu 2 1. And the volume of this cylinder is 251.5 meters cubed. This is going to be the volume of this tank when it is half full.